I've heard this bill 2 years in a row now in Judiciary, and we've had a good discussion, but there are some things we need to focus on, members, on this bill. And one is the simple concept of co-equal branches of government. As you know, I'm an attorney, but believe me, I am not exactly a walk in line with the judicial branch and judges, but I do respect our Chief Justice Nancy Rice. I do respect and honor co-equal branches of government and the need for us to not overstep our bounds. This bill, not only dangerously, but in my view, does overstep those bounds. By the Constitution, our Supreme Court and our Chief Justice has the right and power to delegate to the chief judge of each judicial district control over their courtrooms, control over the safety of their courtrooms, control over the procedures in their courtrooms. Last year, we heard a shocking story of a small county judge in the middle of nowhere, Colorado. Happened to be a lady judge, maybe 120 pounds. She had an overweight bailiff slash deputy sheriff as her only courtroom assistants. Some juveniles were arrested. They happened to be big, strong, 17-year-old type guys. Should it be up to that judge to decide what's in the best interest of the safety of herself, the jurors, the other witnesses in the courtroom, or should it be this legislature trying to decide there should never be any shackling? In that particular case, one of the juveniles broke loose, went out a side door, and was running down the main street of the little town. And this overweight bailiff had to chase him down, and finally, with some good luck and some assistance, caught the guy. Fortunately, that guy didn't go in and grab a witness or a clerk or somebody else, an innocent victim.
Were you good on the second one?
The chief judge has worked very hard, as she does on all judicial issues, whether it's the facilities or anything else. We get to hear her give her state of the judiciary, and I think you'll agree with me. She's a highly intelligent, highly effective leader. She's gone around to all these judicial districts and met with the chief judges of the districts to make sure they're working on a correct plan tailored to their courtrooms to deal with shackling. Why in the world wouldn't we let the chief justice and the chief judges of each judicial district decide what's safest in their courtrooms, including this concept of shackling? And I know there's some stigma involved, and it may be embarrassing, but I also heard a witness in a school safety act say that one of the things that scared him straight as a juvenile was having to appear in court with shackles on, and he was embarrassed. But you know what? He was there for a reason, and he knew it. His whole life changed. So a little negative feedback isn't a bad thing. So I think we're overemphasizing the stress of being shackled to the risk of overstepping our bounds on co-equal branches of government and the safety of our courtrooms. Leave this to the chief judge of each judicial district, led by the Supreme Court Chief Justice Nancy Rice. Thank you, members. Vote no on this.